concerns that the impact of this application will have on the immediate area, the existing residents of the area, and so I would be moving refusal on those grounds.
Okay, is moved refusal, is the second one?
On the reasons for refusal, and in words, we have in words. just the clarity, you know.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm happy to move refusal on the grounds that this application will have a detrimental impact on the immediacy of the area to the existing residential properties.
Would this open up for you to go on the conservation area?
It's not HS4, it's HS13 because it's a conversion to self-contained flats. Rather than new housing development. So are you saying that it would have a detrimental impact on the unities of the area by virtue of
the volume of the dwellings in that area cumulatively on that end of the road will have a detrimental impact to the residential nature of the road?
Regardless of nothing to do with the conservation area.
I'm not mentioning the conservation area or
okay.
Okay.
So Councillor Lewis has moved refusal. Councillor Watt has seconded that. All those in favour of refusal? Those against? Okay, that's lost.
I did move approval, I don't think that's
okay, what I would like to put to committee is that when we heard from the agent, he actually talked about a condition regarding the balcony, and I think you should probably think about that one. And also in relation to the fact that he's offering additional car parking spaces. Now I know that this is in the conservation area, and it flies in the face of having trees, bushes, etc. But on the basis of the residents are telling us, the ward councillor is telling us, that there are problems with parking in that area, does this committee view that we should look to have a condition for those additional car parking spaces within the dwellings that they've said that they can actually provide that additional car parking space, or do we want to preserve the nature of the conservation area? So I'll put that out to members for comment.
With the express view that when Reynolds the site visited, we had that conversation on the site, and it was at the express wish of the advisory council that they didn't provide extra car parking spaces because if they wish to protect the conservation area. So we can't if we give advice and the applicant goes by it, then we give the wrong advice. It's in line with our car parking policies, and the policies are all built to other colleagues around the table. So, but if the offer's there and the committee want to take it. But this is exactly what I was trying to do with the other application about talking about conditions as we move to approval, and I was disallowed from doing it. So.
Can I just, the solicitor's advice is that we can do this as long as we have the additional conditions. Now what I'm saying to members is that it's in a conservation area. Do we want to retain the conservation area and not have the additional car parking, or do we want to look to have the additional car parking? And I'm going to comment to people. Stuart.
I think it might be useful if we could see the layout of the plan, because I think we received the opinion that the addition of, say, two more spaces on the site would take away. I can't picture, I'm afraid, being unable to go on Tuesday, say, business, where it's being suggested the two car parking places would go. So it might be useful, it might help. Reach, certainly myself, we reach a conclusion as to whether the site could take two car parking spaces without detriment to the conservation area, if it was aware of the site layout. Is that the best layout we have? It doesn't show any planting or...
So in essence, it's two parking spaces here and three at the back.
So where would the other two be situated that is causing you the concern that would impact on the conservation?
This is the point, I don't know. It's a suggestion that's been put forward to us by the applicant. As officers, our view is that the additional parking is not needed because the parking that's set out in this application is in line with our supplementary planning document. If, however, members feel that additional parking is required, then we could put a condition on that reads something along the lines of notwithstanding the approved plan, and that's going on the assumption that the plan is approved, but notwithstanding the approved plan, no development shall take place before full details of the number, layout and location of car parking spaces has been submitted to and approved by the local planning authority. Before first occupation, these parking spaces shall be provided in accordance with the approved details, etc. So it needs an opening for us to negotiate with the applicant where those additional spaces would go and how many.
From my point of view, where I'm coming from with this, obviously, is that obviously there's been a refusal and that's been lost. What I'm saying is that they've offered additional car parking spaces and that is part of the problem. So from my point of view, I just felt that if we had that condition in place, it might change people's views on whether they supported the application or not. And also, sorry, just prior to that, Matthew, I would like to see a condition we got in the balcony as well, if this was going to be approved. So if they said they could actually do some privacy screening and to the room as well.
Again, sorry through you, Chair, it reads along the lines of notwithstanding the approved plans, details of privacy screens, usually 1.8 metres in height, obscure delays should be submitted to us for prior approval. So it's something along those lines that we could put a condition on, yes.
Thank you. Can I just go to Phil now, to Stuart?
Sorry, I was going to comment on what Stuart says, and so if he's about to change it, I'll have to hear it first.
Okay. I'll ask the question.
I was just going to say, I think I'm more satisfied with the form of way that's been developed by Matthew than this idea that we are definitely going to do something. Yeah. It's not unusual for us to read or to read conditions that allow officers to agree after the event various aspects of it. Even in this case, condition four requires the landscape scheme to be agreed by officers before the planning commission is put into place. So, having heard the views of this head reading petitioners and the members, and if it's possible, then yes, we probably ought to add a couple of conditions. But again, delegate to officers the agreement of a parking scheme that doesn't fall foul of the conservation. It might fall foul of the parking policy, and I'm happy to dig it out, but the parking policy that we have is actually slightly more detailed than just one pair flat. It does go on to talk about and less and less and less, notwithstanding Steve's broad experience on the appeal. But I mean, coming back to appeals, if I may, just for what form of it is, I have also been to appeals where we have gone against the advice of our highways officers, where the inspector has not agreed with our highways officers. I mean, so sometimes with appeals, it is you pay when you take your choice. So I don't judge his applications on what I believe will happen on appeal, because believe me, anything could happen.
Well, in an application where I tried whilst during approval, where I was trying to get a promise from the developer to be enshrined in a condition, I was told I was out of order. I tried to on the Beckner Park one to ensure that the offer of the Valen treatment would be in keeping with Beckner Park, with the wishes of Beckner Park. I was refused to do that. But we make it up to go along, I'll go along with it, but that would be real fun, isn't it?
Steve, there is already a condition regarding the rail, so I don't think that you are overruled or
in the law.
Unless anyone's got to anything.
I've got Phil coming in and then we'll put it to Jeff.
Sorry, guys, I just wanted to see that if I'm happy to go first, because it was around that was when I concerned. So, for clarity, if you look at the conservation area,
the issue about the car parking is probably being overcomplicated, really. The simple issue is this. If committee accept that 5 parking spaces on this site is satisfactory, there's no need for an additional condition. If, however, you feel that 5 spaces is non-satisfactory and you would want to see additional parking spaces on the site, then we can add that condition and we can talk to the applicant later on to have additional cars parking spaces, whether that's 1 space or 2 spaces or 3 spaces, I don't know, but that's the purpose of the condition at this stage. It's details to be submitted to us for further approval. Just here, if you look on the plan, there were two ISSs originally. One is being